Hi friends, and welcome to a brand new video on my YouTube channel. My name is Artemakis Artemiou, founder of SQL NetHub, and in this video we're going to talk about how you can install SQL Server 2018 Express Edition and the latest version of SQL Server Management Studio. For more information about my community activities and other great stuff like articles, software, online courses, and much more, you can visit sqlnethub.com. Also, for more videos, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, SQL NetHub TV. So, what will you learn in this video? First, we are going to talk about SQL Server Express Edition. So, among other, you are going to learn what SQL Server Express Edition is. Then, we are going to talk about the limitations of SQL Server Express Edition. Moreover, we are going to download and install SQL Server 2018 Express Edition on a demo Windows VM. In addition to that, we are going to download and install the latest SSMS, that is SQL Server Management Studio, and we are going to connect to the SQL Server Express instance earlier created using SQL Server Management Studio. So let's talk more about SQL Server Express Edition. Well, SQL Server Express Edition is a special free edition of SQL Server, and that makes SQL Server Express Edition ideal for development and production for desktop, web, and small server applications. However, when compared with the rest of SQL Server editions, the Express Edition of SQL Server has certain limitations. So let's talk more about these limitations in order to get the feeling of what exactly you get when using SQL Server Express Edition and what else you don't get. So some of the main limitations of SQL Server Express Edition are the below. First of all, a SQL Server Express Edition Database Engine instance can use up to 1 GB maximum RAM. This is an important limitation because with 1 GB maximum RAM, you can actually use the SQL Server Express Edition Database Engine instance for hosting small databases and handling relatively low workload. Another limitation is that the maximum size per relational database in a SQL Server Express Database Engine instance is 10 GB. So if you have a database that needs to exceed the limit of 10 GB, you will need to upgrade your SQL Server instance to another paid edition of SQL Server. Another important limitation is that SQL Agent is not included, and that means that you cannot easily have automations in the sense of jobs that undertake certain tasks. Of course, there are ways of overcoming this issue by scheduling different processes in your SQL Server Express instance using other approaches, for example, Windows Schedule Tasks. Another limitation is the maximum buffer pool memory per instance, which is limited to 1,410 MB, as well as the maximum memory for Columnstore segment cache per instance of SQL Server Database Engine when talking about the Express Edition is 352 MB. In addition to that, the maximum memory optimized data size per database in SQL Server Database Engine of the Express Edition of SQL Server is again 352 MB. There are many more limitations. These are some of the main limitations. You can learn more about the limitations of SQL Server Express Edition by following the below link, where you can compare all editions of SQL Server 2018 and check what features are offered in each edition of SQL Server. Now, about downloading and installing SQL Server 2018 Express Edition, you can download this edition of SQL Server by visiting this link. This is the official SQL Server download webpage. And the requirements for installing SQL Server 2018 Express Edition are the below. So first of all, you need to have a minimum of 6 GB of available hard disk space. Also, you need to have a minimum of 512 MB of RAM and an x64 processor with a minimum speed of 1.4 GHz. Now, when it comes to the operating system, you need to have Windows 10, TH1 1507 or greater, or Windows Server 2016 or greater. Now, about downloading and installing the latest SSMS, you can download SSMS on the following link. Note that there is not a specialized edition of SSMS for SQL Server Express Edition, because SSMS is now a free tool. It is not distributed with the installation media of SQL Server. It is a standalone tool, and you can download the latest version of SSMS by visiting the official webpage of the tool. Now, about the requirements for installing SSMS. First, you need to have at least an x86 processor with a speed of 1.8 GHz or faster. You need to have a minimum of 2 GB RAM and a minimum of 2 GB up to 10 GB of available space. When it comes to the OS support, you need to have Windows 8.1 64-bit or Windows 10 64-bit version 1607 or later. Additionally, regarding the Windows Server OS, SSMS can be also installed on Windows Server 2008 R2 64-bit or a later 64-bit Windows Server version. Great, so now we are ready to proceed to a live demonstration where we are going to download and install SQL Server 2018 Express Edition on a demo Windows VM, along with downloading and installing the latest version of SQL Server Management Studio. So here we are in our demo Windows VM, where I'm going to download SQL Server 2018 Express Edition, install it, and then proceed with the download and installation of SSMS. And finally, we're going to connect to the SQL Server Express Edition instance in order to navigate through the database objects. So first, in order to download SQL Server Express Edition, you need to visit the official download page of SQL Server, which is the one presented in the lecture earlier. So this is the URL, and you can see here you have many options. You can try SQL Server on Azure, SQL Server for IoT devices, SQL Server for premises. You can download the free trial, or you can download the free specialized edition. So in our case, I'm going to download the Express Edition of SQL Server 2018. So I click here. So now our installer will be downloaded. I'm going to save this in a directory I'm going to create, and I'm going to name it software. So let's save the installer of the Express Edition of SQL Server there. Okay. Let's close the internet browser, and now let's double click in order to start the installation. So this is the installer of SQL Server 2018 Express Edition, and here you have three options regarding the installation type. You can either use the basic installation type that installs SQL Server Database Engine with default configuration. You can then choose, if you like, the second installation type, which is custom, where you select the features to be included in the installation of SQL Server Express Edition, or you can download the media. Now, if you want to reuse this media for installing SQL Server Express Edition on another machine, you can select Download Media. Since I want to show how you can get the ISO of SQL Server Express Edition, I'm going to select Download Media. So you have some more options here. You can download SQL Server Express Core. This is just the database engine of SQL Server Express Edition. You have the option of downloading SQL Server Express Advanced, which also includes features such as full text services and reporting services, or LocalDB, where LocalDB, it is a lightweight version of SQL Server Express Edition with all of its programmability features, but runs in user mode. So in our case, I'm going to download just the Express Core Edition of SQL Server. I'm going to save my ISO in C software. And now let's click on download. So depending on your internet connection speed, this download process might take from a few seconds up to a few minutes. During this download of SQL Server Express Edition, the installer provides you with some useful tips. For example, if you are interested in using sample databases of SQL Server, you can visit the GitHub repositories. You can find support about SQL Server in forums, in the MSDN forums. You can follow the SQL Server Twitter account in order to stay up to date with the latest news of SQL Server and much more. So the download was successful. We click on close, and back to C software, you can see now this is the actual offline installer of SQL Server Express Edition. In the case of SQL Server Express Edition, this is an executable, it is not an ISO file, so no need to mount it, you just double click and the installation will begin. Okay, so the first step is to choose the directory for extracting the files. So let's leave the default, so in our C software directory, a new directory will be created with the name sql_x64_enu. So we click OK, and now the installation files of SQL Server Express Edition are extracted into this directory. Right after the extraction of the files is completed, the actual installation process will begin, where we will be able to select different options for the setup of our SQL Server 2018 Express instance. So this is the installation center, and here you have options, so you can perform a new SQL Server standalone installation or add features to an existing installation, install SQL Server reporting services, management tools, SQL Server data tools, or upgrade from a previous version of SQL Server. So if, for example, you have here installed SQL Server 2016 Express Edition, you can upgrade to SQL Server 2018 Express Edition with the option upgrade from a previous version of SQL Server. However, since we are performing a fresh installation of SQL Server Express Edition, we will be selecting the first option here, that is new SQL Server standalone installation or add features to an existing installation. Okay, this is the license agreement for installing SQL Server 2018 Express Edition. So if you accept the agreement, you can then proceed with the rest of the installation. In this step, you can use Microsoft Update to check for updates. So if there is an update for this SQL Server version, this update will be automatically downloaded and included in this installation. Since I have just downloaded SQL Server 2018 Express Edition, and this specific build I just downloaded from the official website, it is the latest one, there's no need at this point to use Microsoft Update to check for updates because I'm using the latest build. So now the setup files are installed in order to allow me to further set the installation rules for my SQL Server instance. So now the process further proceeds, and in a while we'll be ready to set our installation rules, and that means that we will be actually configuring this new SQL Server instance. Okay. So the main rules for installing SQL Server are okay. I get a warning for Windows Firewall, so that mentions that the Windows Firewall is enabled, and you need to make sure that the appropriate ports are open in order to enable remote access. So this is not a prerequisite for proceeding with installation of SQL Server, so you can also ignore this if you do not intend to use remote access for your SQL Server instance. So let's proceed. And here you select what to install. So you can install Database Engine Services, which is the actual database instance, and you can also install SQL Client Connectivity SDK. The SQL Client Connectivity SDK is a shared feature. So here you select where to place these binaries. Since this is a simple demo VM, I'm just using a C drive, so I will keep the default options here, but if you would like to use another drive in your environment, if you have more drives, you can consider installing these binaries to another drive. However, these binaries do not take so much space, so it is okay to use C drive as well. In addition to Database Engine Services, you can select to include SQL Server Replication, and with SQL Server Replication, you can have publishers and subscribers, so you can send data from a central SQL Server instance to other instances that act as subscribers. I will not be demonstrating this functionality in this demo, so I will leave the SQL Server Replication feature out of this demo, so I will just be installing Database Engine Services and SQL Client Connectivity SDK. Great. So in the Instance Configuration tab, you are presented with two options. You can either install this instance of SQL Server as a default instance or as a named instance. The difference between these two is the following. If you install the SQL Server instance as a default instance, it means that you will be connecting to the SQL Server instance by specifying the machine name. In a different case where you are going to install it as a named instance, you will need to specify a name. And in order to connect to SQL Server, you will need to specify the machine name or the server name / instance name. So in this case, I'm going to use a named instance. So I'm going to name my instance SQL Express 2K19. So you can see the instance ID is also updated based on my named instance value. So in order to connect to my SQL Server instance later using SSMS, I will need to specify localhost or the machine name / SQL Express 2K19. Personally, I prefer using named instances of SQL Server because in many cases in the names, I specify also the version of the SQL Server instance. Now, the next step is the Server Configuration tab, where you need to set two things. First, you need to set the service accounts to be used for starting the SQL Server Database Engine and the SQL Server Browser Service, as well as the collation. Now, the collation provides supportability for additional characters in your SQL Server databases and tables. So if you have characters that are not just Latin, so for example, if you use Greek, you can select here to use a Greek collation in order to also support Greek characters. So in this case, I'm selecting Greek. I'm specifying that it is accent sensitive and case insensitive, for example. If you want to have sensitivity for the case letters as well, you define case sensitive, binary with sensitive, and so on. So in this case, I'm just selecting accent sensitive. So my collation will be Greek case insensitive accent sensitive. So by using this collation, I will be able to include in my varchar columns, text, and other string related columns Greek characters in addition to the Latin characters which are natively supported. Now, if I don't select the Greek collation here and just leave the Latin collation, another option for supporting Greek characters or any other characters in my SQL Server instance besides the Latin characters is to use Unicode. So instead of using varchar, for example, I can use nvarchar and so on. But however, since I want to make this a more localized installation of SQL Server and I want to be able to be including Greek characters in my SQL Server tables without using Unicode in order to save storage, I will be using the Greek case-insensitive, accent-sensitive collation. Now, back to service account. Here you have the option to use a local Windows account or use the default ones, or if you are in domain, the best practice is to use domain users. And when I'm talking about domain users, I'm not talking about domain administrators. I'm talking about plain domain users, and the SQL Server installation will grant the necessary rights in order for this user to be able to start the database engine on the machine. So since this is a live demonstration on a simple demo VM, I will be using the default accounts suggested by the SQL Server installation wizard. So let's click on next. And the next step, which is very important, is the database engine configuration. So now we need to set different options regarding our new SQL Server instance. So here you can see some tabs, server configuration, data directories, tempdb, memory, user instances, filestream, and so on. So let's thoroughly talk about these options. So in the server configuration tab, you need to set the authentication mode and which users will have sysadmin access to the SQL Server instance. And that means that there will be SQL Server administrators. So here you have the option to use Windows authentication mode or mixed mode. Now, when using Windows authentication mode, that means that only Windows users or also Active Directory users, if you are on a domain, will be able to be granted access to this SQL Server instance. However, if you use mixed mode, it means that you will be also able to create local users with their passwords in the SQL Server instance in order to connect to this instance of SQL Server. Now, the security best practices recommend to use only Windows authentication mode, but actually this depends on the type of applications whose databases will be hosted in this instance of SQL Server. However, since I like following security best practices, I will be selecting the Windows authentication mode here. So, right after this step, you need to specify the SQL Server administrators. This is very important because you need to be careful in this step in order not to lock yourself out. So in this step, you need to include at least one user to the SQL Server administrator's role. So you can see that by default, the current user I'm using, this is the demo user. The name of my machine is demo VM. So this is, as you can see, a Windows user, but you can also add more users by using this dialog. And so this allows you to find more local Windows users to be included as server administrators in the SQL Server instance. If you are on a domain, you can change the location and select the domain, and from there search for the domain user you want to grant SQL Server administrator access. You need to be very careful in this step, not only for not locking yourself out of the SQL Server instance, but also for granting sysadmin access, that is SQL Server administrator access, to the proper persons. So in this demo, I will be the only user, so my user demo will be granted SQL Server administrator access. However, note, before talking about the data directories, if you select mixed mode, you will also need to specify the password for the SQL Server system administrator, that is the well-known SA account. And in this case, you need to enter here and confirm a really strong password, because this is the built-in SQL Server system administrator account. But since I will be using Windows authentication mode, there is no need to do that here, because only Windows users are allowed access to my SQL Server instance. Now, the next step is to set the data directories. SQL Server performance best practices recommend to use different data directories and different log directories, as well as a different directory for TempDB. In this case, where I'm using a simple demo VM with only a SYN drive, I will be keeping the default options here. However, if you are installing SQL Server Express Edition on a production environment, it is highly recommended to use separate disks for the data, another separate disk for the logs, and a separate disk for the TempDB system database. And this is recommended in order to help the SQL Server instance to have more performance by utilizing parallelism on the disk level. So I will be keeping the defaults in this demo environment, and the next step is to set TempDB. So as mentioned earlier, it is recommended to use a separate disk for TempDB as well in order to help SQL Server to be more performant with its I/O operations. And in this case, if I had a dedicated disk for TempDB, I would specify it here in the data directories and in the log directory. However, since this is not the case in this demo environment, because I just have a C drive, I will be keeping the default options here. Some other configuration options for TempDB. Here you have some recommended values for the number of data files, initial size, auto growth, as well as initial size and auto growth for the log file. Note that here I get the recommendation for one file. This depends on the number of logical cores you have on your machine. This is a simple VM for demonstration purposes. It has just one logical core, so the number of files suggested here for the data files of TempDB is one. But in case I had a better machine, and this machine, let's say it had 16 logical cores, the recommendation here would be to have 8 data files for TempDB. And this is the maximum recommended value for data files for the TempDB system database, and the performance best practice recommendation here is to re-evaluate this option, that is the number of 8 data files for TempDB, only if you observe contention in the operation of your SQL Server instance. So let's go to the memory tab, and again here you get recommendation for the min and max server memory to be used, and this puts a limit to the RAM that can be used from the SQL Server instance, or you can choose to use the default, which means that SQL Server will be able to use all the available memory on your environment. Since I want to use the recommendations here, because I have 3 GB of RAM in this demo VM, so the recommendation is to have a minimum server memory 0 MB and the maximum, that is the ceiling of RAM that can be used by SQL Server, to be 1,203 MB. So I will use the recommendation here, and I need to accept the recommended memory configuration for the SQL Server Database Engine. So this is an additional step in order to be fully aware of this configuration step you are taking here. And the next tab is the User Instances tab. So in this tab, you can specify if users who do not have administrative permission can run a separate instance of the database engine. So this allows you to do that if you click this checkbox. So if you do that, users that are not SQL Server system administrators will be able to run a separate instance of the database engine. So I will be using this option in order to make the operation of my SQL Server instance more efficient. And last but not least, you can enable or disable FileStream for transact SQL access. But since FileStream is out of the scope of this live demonstration, we will not be enabling it. But in order to provide some more information about this feature, the FileStream feature in SQL Server allows you to store large unstructured data, for example, binary files, videos, music, images, and so on the file system, and control this data via a set of metadata from within SQL Server tables. This is a great feature in SQL Server, and at some point you should definitely check it out. Okay, we're ready to proceed with the installation. So the installation begins, and based on all the configuration options I have made in the previous steps, the SQL Server 2018 Express Edition instance is being installed on my virtual machine. So now we see that the installation of our SQL Server 2018 Express instance has just been completed, and we can close this installation wizard now. So now let's confirm that this newly installed instance is up and running. So we navigate to Programs, we open the Microsoft SQL Server 2018 folder, and there you can see that we can find SQL Server 2018 Configuration Manager. This is the built-in configuration tool for SQL Server, and from there we can check the status of the SQL Server services. So we go to the SQL Server Services tab here, and you can see that SQL Server, that is SQL Express 2K19, that is the name of the instance we specified in the installation process, is up and running, and the start mode is set to automatic. Also, you can see that SQL Server Agent, it is stopped, and if you try to start it, it is not possible to do that because SQL Server Agent is not supported in the Express Edition of SQL Server. So you can see, even though I changed the start mode to automatic and tried to start it, it does not start because it is not supported in the Express Edition of SQL Server. Okay, so let's change again the start mode to disabled. And of course, in case you upgrade at some point the instance of SQL Server from Express Edition to another edition of SQL Server, for example, Standard Edition or Enterprise Edition, you will be able to use SQL Server Agent as well. So now we are ready to proceed with the next part of this live demonstration, where we are going to download the latest version of SSMS, that is SQL Server Management Studio, and install it in order to be able to connect to this SQL Server Express Edition we have just installed. So in order to download SQL Server Management Studio, we need to visit the official webpage of the tool. This is the URL provided in the previous lecture, but also if you don't have the link, with a simple search in your browser, you can find the SSMS webpage. So this is the page for SSMS, the official Microsoft webpage for SQL Server Management Studio. And from here, you can download the latest version of SSMS. At the point of recording this video, the latest version of SSMS is SSMS 18.7.1, but I'm sure that if you are watching this video at a later point in time, most probably there will be a newer version of SSMS. Also note that SSMS is a standalone tool, so as mentioned in the lecture as well, there is not an express edition of SSMS, there is just one tool, and that is SSMS. It is free, it is standalone, and you can download it freely from the official website. And this is the website via which we can download SSMS. So I will be clicking on Download SQL Server Management Studio, SSMS, and the download will begin. Note that you need 64-bit version of Windows for installing SSMS. So let's save the installer to C software, just like we did earlier. So let's save the installer of SSMS again in C software. So let's click on save and then download will begin. So again, depending on your internet connection speed, this might take from a few seconds up to a few minutes. So let's wait a bit in order for the downloading to be completed in order to be able to start the installation of SSMS. So a few minutes later, you can see that the download of SSMS is completed. So let's open the folder that is C software. And this is the installer. Let's double click on it. So here you can change the location on the disk where the program will be installed. I'll be using the default one. It is in C program files x86. SSMS is a 32-bit application. So let's click on install. Now the proper packages are being loaded in order for the installation to proceed. You can see that the installation is progressing. You can get more information here during the installation process on what package is being deployed. Depending on the speed of your computer, it might take up to a few minutes in order for the installation to be completed. So a few minutes later, we can see that the installation of SSMS has been successfully completed, but it asks us to restart the machine. So let's perform restart and get back again to our demo environment in order to use SSMS and connect to the newly installed SQL Server Express instance. So here we are back to our demo environment, just right after the restart, since we installed SSMS and the restart was suggested by the installation wizard of the tool. So now we go to Programs, and we can see that besides the Microsoft SQL 2019 folder, you can also see another folder, which is called Microsoft SQL Server Tools 18. And in this folder, you can find the client tools that were installed along with this latest version of SQL Server Management Studio, that is SSMS. So there is the Analysis Services Deployment Wizard, Database Engine Tuning Advisor, and SQL Server Profiler. We're going to talk about these tools in other videos. But at this point, let's talk about the Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio 18 tool here, which is the core tool, that is SSMS. So if we click here, SSMS will launch, and from there we will be able to enter the details for the SQL Server instance we want to connect to. So you can see this is the splash screen of Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. And this is the first dialog we get as soon as SSMS is started. So now I need to specify the details in order for SSMS to connect to the proper SQL Server instance. So here I select the database engine. It is the default option as well, so no need to change that. And then you need to specify the server name. So if you remember from the installation of the SQL Server instance, I specified this instance of SQL Server as an empty instance and not a default instance. If it was a default instance of SQL Server, I wouldn't need to include here the name of the named instance. So I would just put the machine name or dot or localhost, and that would be okay. However, since this is an empty instance of SQL Server, along with the machine name or localhost or the dot sign, I need to also specify the name of the SQL Server instance. So in order to connect, you will need to use dot backslash SQL Express 2K19, which is the name of the SQL Server instance, or use demo VM backslash SQL Express 2K19, and so on. So let's connect to our named instance. I'm using Windows authentication. I cannot use SQL Server authentication here, because if I try to use it, it wouldn't make any sense because I haven't enabled SQL Server authentication during the installation of SQL Server. So my SQL Server instance supports only Windows authentication. So you can see that when you select Windows authentication here, SQL Server Management Studio automatically detects the context of the Windows user under which you launched SSMS. And it is with this Windows user that SSMS will try to connect to the SQL Server instance. Now, if you want to run SSMS as a different user and try to connect to the SQL Server instance, that user also needs to be authorized for connecting to the SQL Server instance. So if you haven't included that user to the SQL Server logins, you can do that from within SQL Server right after you connect with the first user you defined during the installation, in this case, the demo user. So let's connect to the SQL Server instance. And yes, you can see that the connection to the SQL Server Express instance was successful. So from here, you can navigate to the different database objects in this SQL Server instance. You can see you can navigate to databases. Currently, there are no user databases since this is a new instance of SQL Server. You can view the system databases, master, model, MSDB, and tempdb. If you right-click on databases, you can create a new database. So let's name it testdb. And you can see this is the newly created database. Under security, you can check the logins for this SQL Server instance. So you can see that this is our user. Let's check its properties. And you can see in the server roles, it is assigned the sysadmin role. And our user is assigned the sysadmin role because we included our user as a SQL Server system administrator during installation. So let's run a special query in order to verify some information about our SQL Server instance. So let's run select to add signs version. This is a global variable SQL Server, which returns version information about the SQL Server instance. So yes, you can see that this is a SQL Server 2019 Express Edition on a Windows VM. You can find more information by running other queries, query system objects in SQL Server. So the engine edition is 4. This stands for Express Edition, which is great. So in this video, in this live demonstration, we downloaded SQL Server 2018 Express Edition, along with the latest version of SQL Server Management Studio, that is SSMS, and we installed this on a new Windows demo VM. So we went through this process step by step, and finally, using SSMS, we connected to the SQL Server Express instance we installed earlier, and we navigated through different database objects. We ran a query in order to double check the version of the SQL Server instance, and so on. If you want to stay up to date with our latest videos, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We regularly upload educational videos on different interesting technology topics, such as SQL Server development, administration and tuning, HR SQL and other cloud computing topics, programming and .NET, entity framework, and much more. Thank you very much for watching this video.